Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Menzoberranzan. In today's episode, we are going to continue exploring the Dwarven Mines and see how far we can get before people start croaking from poison. Well, mostly just Manorath, or whatever his name is. Anyways, we're going to jump right into that, and I'm going to make note that I'm clicking continue game right now. I'm doing that because last video, well actually, it's actually a DOSBox recording related thing where, like, DOSBox starts recording like a second later than I start talking, so I gotta sync stuff up. Man, I really wish I had like a way to detect magic, because I would swear that damn short sword is magical. It hits way too hard. Because I don't even think Vonar has like a... Yeah, he has a... Like, I think a strength 16 is like a plus 1 to maybe damage, and that's about it. So, yeah. And what do we have here? A mace! Well, we'll hold on to that so she has something to hit things with. I suppose that counts for something. And another door. These auto doors confuse and terrify me. No monsters, okay. Manahath, you, I think, are going to die. I don't think that we have anything that will help you. So you are going to become a glorified item holder now. And, yeah, that really sucks, because I don't know of any way to revive him, actually. Like, I know clerics obviously get, like, raised dead, but that's a damn high-level spell, and I know clerics don't advance the same in, 2nd edition as they do in 3rd 3.5 in regards to their spell progression. So it could be a... It could be a while before we see a raised dead spell. Oh god. Get out of here. Wait, he can attack from the back row with a two-hander? Really? That's different. Actually, I want to give her that shield. There. Vonar, why are you not two up and fighting? Murder it! Murder it with fire! Okay, so we've got at least two more in here. Probably more than that. I'm still kind of surprised that we haven't seen any casters yet. They look different from these guys, I believe. I think they have like the little headbands. Just a little farts. Okay. Yeah, there's one more in here. Is it here? No, next corner. Let's do this! Ouch, that one hit. Oh, Manahath leveled! And gained 3 hit points, or 4 maybe. She is getting really close, and she's gonna be hitting level 8, which I believe will just net her more spells. The lack of... Man, this freaking sucks. And we're to the point now that I ain't going back and replaying stuff. So if he croaks, we'll just have to make do with 3 for the time being. I could go back possibly and talk to that one crazy dude that was before the Aboleth. He'd probably be a bit saner now. But I don't know. Kiak Tom's ointment? No, a candle. That's interesting. We will hold on to it. I wonder if it actually does anything. Okay. Well, that's something. so it looks like we are going to be going through these doors up here. Okay. Oh! New area. Dang, not what I was expecting. Alright, these are the dwarven areas I remember. Okay, so we're gonna save. I think now we're gonna start bumping into their spellcaster guys. I think they're called, like, savants, maybe? I know that's what they're called in actual D&D, but I don't know how close to it they're sticking in this. Interesting. Little mountain holes, and I see something over here. I know it's stupid to just rush in like this. Oh, Cloud Kill. That's a spell he is not going to use for many, many, many levels. Oh, mana hath. I am so sorry, bud. You little bastards. Oh. What do we got? What do we got? Ugh, another short sword. Well, I could probably have him dual wield them. It'd be faster attacking than what he currently is. Oh, I think we shouldn't have run in here. Although they do appear to be kind of stuck on the furniture. Okay. And looks like just some fancy tables over this way. Button. Oh damn, this is a hallway. We'll go right across. Ooh, pile of items. Got some weapons. I want frickin'. I don't really care about these weapons. I want frickin' Kyogtom's ointment. I mean, yeah, they're all well and good. And I'm going to take them all because some of them. I'm not going to take that. Some of them might be magical, and I'm sure some of these probably are. A pick we don't need. Another short sword. Dang. Okay, so pick crossbow, and we'll continue on. How much health does he have left? Alright, he's at 4 hit points, so what I think I'm going to do, 3 hit points, is save here. And we'll kind of poke around, and if he dies, we'll keep poking around. But if he dies and we find Kyogtom's ointment somewhere in this level, we'll reload and get it. Oh, you bastard. You little dwarf fart. Actually, I think I'm going to give Vonar that. Oh, she just leveled. Yay. There you go, Vonar. You can be our little Tempest fighter guy. You're so freaking awesome. Yay for high attacks. Wait, can you, like, not. You can't dual wield short swords. That's different. Okay. Their two weapon fighting code is flawed, I think. Oh, I saw something tiny and I'm like, Kyogtom's ointment? And the game is like, no. Oh, that was disappointing right there. Although I think this is one of the keys because they mentioned a hammer. Does this actually do anything? This helm does not appear to do anything. We will, however, hold on to it. It may be magical. I will give them points for there being just all kinds of crap in here. And I bet you there's all kinds of. Well, that room bespeaks of death. We'll just kind of waddle our way past. Neutralize poison. Yeah, just as good. Well, not just as good. But, 7 hit points. That counts for something, and she's back to mace hitting things. Here are my 3 damage. Ooh, 6. A solid blow. Oh, Vonar. Was not expecting that. Well, we're gonna keep running, and, gonna move Swell back up front here. Swell, have the two-weapon fighting again. And melee! Vonar dying, that kinda displeases me. So at this point, I'm more or less just going to, poke around in search of Kyogdom's ointment. Run. Are there items in this room? No, although there's something up against that wall. Oh my god, Soul just went down. What is this over here? Okay. Run. And we'll come down here. Holy crap. Kind of overshot a little bit. My gosh, this is just like barren. Anything? No. Okay, it looks like then that we are going to Triangle Room. Because that appears. I take that back, there's stuff down here. Yet. There we are. Actually, since we're just running around, see, she's at 1. Get her to -1. -2. -4. There. She is not going to be hit. the impervious cleric of God mode. And what have we up here? No! We shouldn't be seeing things. Quiet, but look here, to this hole in the wall, it provides a window to the room beyond, a window of treachery.
Arrogant Darrow, how dare you refuse a priestess of House O'Bludra? We helped you take over this temple from the dwarves, forging an alliance that we, as Drow, will not soon forget. Now comes your time to hold to our bargain. The same Drow blades that drove your...
Our agreement stands. A day, a week, we argue timing. As yet, we have not reached the fountain. It lies below, as I've said. The drink from it will make the difference. A day, a week, and the fountain will be mine.
Of this fountain, I know nothing. For this fountain, I care not. Certainly you have felt it, the tremors in the Underdark. Many houses prepare for secret attacks upon one another. Our enemies in House Barrison del Armgo prepare a spell, one which will enable them to swallow up House of Bludra. The claw rift within the city will widen and we will be gone. It is now you must attack.
Uh-oh. Snake whip.
Yes, I shall lead the attack. But ho, what more will my Darrow be than a diversion? In a war between drow houses, my magic counts for little. But if you allow me to reach the fountain, perhaps that will change things. It is rumored.
Rumors do not interest House O'Bludra. Action does. A diversion is exactly what we need, you fool. With every hour that passes, we are in danger. We need your efforts now, or else every surviving warrior, wizard, and priestess of House O'Bludra will seek you out. Our vengeance shall be slow, measured, and unendurable.
I see. Worry not. My studies are almost complete. I have been poring over these dwarven runes and scrolls, parchments and tomes. Gibberish, almost all gibberish. Best I can see, there may be a treasure down there. But soon, I'll have the answers to the fountain. And then...
You stubborn, impossible embarrassment to my house! Get your men underway now! Forget the fountain! If not, I promise you, its waters will be awash in Darrow blood. The time for words has passed. It is rumored houses Dwarden and Feybranc too prepare for war, that some influence stirs the ambitions of all the drow.
Well, okay then. That was something. There be plotting afoot. Ooh. And somebody be throwing some souls. Wait a minute, go back. Did I see a button? No, I didn't see a button. I'm just going crazy. Crazy, I tell you. Alright. Oh, NPC. Also, items. Torch. Torch. NPC. nothing else. Alright, let's see what this NPC up here is. It looks like something. Yeah. We, aren't gonna bother with him. Jeez. This place does kinda. A keyhole. Yeah. And lo, this has become a solo run. A shield. Dang it. Alright, we'll hit this room over here and see what is what. Ooh, item. Damn it! I don't care about your stupid protection from evil, game. Give me neutralized poison. Night Hunter. I remember this room when my dad first played through this game, every time we'd enter this room and look at those things, the game would crash. And I remember him actually backing through the room, making absolutely sure not to see anything in there. None of the monsters, because there's a key or something we need in there. But I remember him backing through that entire room in an attempt to avoid seeing them. And he actually did it. It might actually be this room that I was thinking of. Yeah. Oh, no, maybe not. But yeah, I remember him doing that. And then it was just like crazy, because I mean, this was back in the time when, you know, internet was not widespread, so, you know, patches and stuff were more or less non-existent, and so you had to just do stuff like that. I believe it was actually what caused the crash was it was audio related, like our sound card wouldn't, when it picked up the sound that those things made, it would just crash the game. Alright, this fight is going to take forever. Get out of my way, you mangy little blue freaking killer smurf. Let me sneak past you here. Follow me in here. Come on. Come on. Yeah, that's it. There we go. I don't care about you, you can't hit me. I think probably has to roll a 20 to hit me, so yeah. Now there's something right up. And this room does not bode death, and we have more or less explored this entire level. And there are no Kyogtom's ointments forthcoming. So I think what we're gonna do is load. And we're gonna sleep. Sorry, warrior barbarian dude, but yeah, your time is kinda up, I am afraid. Get everybody to memorize their spells and stuff here. Everything looks passable. I don't know why it does that when I mouse all the way to the right. It's weird. Anyways, sleep time. Yes, yes. There. Okay, you do light. Actually, memorize. Seriously, he does not have detect magic? Okay. Then pray for. We'll drop bless for detect magic, and we'll actually just keep it prepared, I think. Rest. Cast detect magic. Ah, that short sword is magical. Okay, we picked up a magical longsword too, apparently. And this candle is magical. Okay, so what we do now is have Vonar memorize two improved identify spells, snooze, and cast. And let's see what we've got. A plus two longsword and a plus one short sword. Badass. Okay, and you are going to get back up in the front row. Swell. And there will be ass kicking afoot. And Vonar can have... I think we're going to keep him with, well, 1 to 10, 3 to 18, 1 to 10, 2 to 12. Alright, we're going to give him the two-hander, because he should be proficient with that. Alright, and then the candle was magical, so let's see what it does. Well, that tells me nothing. It's just a white candle. Oh, okay. Can we actually, Huh. Alright, well, we'll hold on to it then. And we'll drop some crap here. Okay, she keeps the mace, keeps the sling. Oh no, in-game video lags. Seriously, Fraps. What the hells? Anyways, while it decides to lag out for the time being, we're gonna exchange equipment here a little bit. Okay, looks good. I think. Yes. When the mouse doesn't move, the game runs fine. I think. More or less, when the mouse moves, it lags. This is interesting. We're going to save. Save, I say. You. Oh, 8. Mana hath dead. Alright, and I'm gonna pause the video here and see if I can puzzle out what the hell is causing this, so I shall return momentarily, folks. Okay, folks, we are back. Let's see if this will actually work. I think I might know what it is, maybe. I've said that in the past, I know, but this time I might have an idea here. So we'll see if the game runs decently for a little while here, and if it does, I think that means that I have figured out what is causing our trouble. Now, what we were doing is dropping off crap, so we don't need the halberd anymore. We don't need... 2 to 5, 1 to 4, 2 to 7, 1 to 6. Mace is better. Non-magical, non-magical, and non-magical. So that said, we've got... God mode. We've got a pretty solid setup here. I mean, our whole party's more or less killing machines. Actually, I'm going to hold on to this halberd. Because if we do get Mana Hath revived, I think I'm going to keep him in the back and bring Goldleaf up front and give him a pole arm. And that way we can have everybody in the party fighting really well, and it should be fairly solid. So let's do some poking around and kill some Darrow. And this time we're going to be buffed to hell because we're awesome. Although before we do anything, I'm going to quickly switch these out for Acid Arrow before I forget. There. Alright. Night Hunter. Now, I don't actually know what these things are. I've never encountered them in D&D or anything. But they're pretty tough, as you can see. Come on. Oh, wow. There are more in here than I thought there were. Okay. Dagger. Don't know if it's magical. I think I'm just gonna run around with Detect Magic on. And this is non-magic, so we'll just ditch it. Wine racks. Now, since a good chunk of this episode was actually just me running around with the one chick. I think we'll probably go a little bit over half an hour today. I think we'll go for, I don't know, 35, 40 minutes. Stupid protection from evil. Because that gets used so much. Alright. I challenge you to Mortal Kombat with burning hands! I love that spell so much. Anybody else? No? I didn't think so. Okay. This wall. Just that they'd have like this little niche here is kinda weird, but whatever. Set Volnar up for a backstab. And with that, we shall proceed onward. It's okay, Manahath. We'll level faster now that we're only splitting XP three ways. Okay, that's the locked door. This is a shield over here, if I remember. Yes. Non-magical. Do not care. Okay. This is the room with Alright, let's see what this guy wants to say. We'll talk. We are in search of drow raiders. There is no need for us to do battle.
No. Never good to fight the big ones alone. Our war, too, is with the drow. So the Savin says. Soon we attack a drow house. Down below. First we look for the great fountain. In the bottom of this place it lies. But we cannot reach it.
Huh. Well, okay. So he was a smart Darrow dwarf. One thing that actually kind of surprises me is that the Darrow are actually sane, I guess you could say, because in 3.5 their whole thing is they're more or less completely crazy. I don't know if it was like that in first and second edition. I never really paid too close attention to them in like the monster manuals or anything. Now. Oh, that's right, there's a stupid frickin' spinner here. And if I remember correctly, like an Umber Hulk or something busts out that wall. Alright, so there's where we'll need a key. Here, let's see if we can get through this. Back into it. And then back for it. Back. We're inching. Hey, I think we made it. Cool. And there's absolutely nothing back here yet. One of these walls seems unusual. Okay. I think it's this one right here. Or maybe not. There we are. A button. Ooh, what the button did, I don't know. Is this wall weird? No. Well, whatever it did, it turned off the crazy spinner thing of confusion and irritability. Okay, so we will come in here. Which I believe is the empty room, yes, with the key. Okay, so rotate. Where's this stupid thing? Ah. How did I get over there? There we go. And we'll just skip this because we've seen it already. Yep. Oh no! Snake whip!
Yeah.
We're gonna go in there and just kill everybody. Because we're pissed off and we're not gonna take it anymore! Rawr, rawr, rawr. Mostly we're just irritated that poor Manahath got wasted. Hold on to that because I don't know if we use it more than once. And I think the savant's in here, and if we don't get up in a melee with him, yep, that's the savant. If you don't melee him, he will frickin' lightning bolt your ass. Our slain foe is dropped. Alright, and I think this is the key that we need to get deeper into this place. But first, we shall poke around. A drow parchment. I don't suppose we can read it. Oh, dang it. Come on. Let it be known that a certain house of the city of Menzoberranzan, known to be in conflict with House Barrison del Armgo, I'm horribly mispronouncing these things, I'm sure, has this day entered into a pact with a certain Darrow, known to be occupying a dwarven temple once a property of the Black Axe clan. Here to tell, never could the Darrow have defeated the dwarves and occupied said temple without the aid of drow warriors loyal to the house in conflict with Barrison del Armgo. In fulfillment of this agreement upon agreed upon contract, it is hereby understood that the Darrow shall, upon request, immediately and forcefully launch an attack against House Barrison del Armgo in payment for the help they received against the dwarves from the enemies of Barrison del Armgo. Well, okay, that is a legal document. What else we got in here? A Dwarven book. And another Dwarven book. Oh, these are going to be probably just... Oh. Can't read them. Darn. Here. I think he should be able to translate it. Then I think I right-clicked. Yes. We honor the brave beards of the Black Axe. We honor the brave beards of the Black Axe clan, those of our ancestors who first stood unyielding before the drow. Merciless in battle, the dark elves would have overwhelmed the clan, yet in the cavern of cloven heads, a handful of dwarves stood their ground, allowing the rest to flee. As those heroes fell, they dealt the blow by which half the forces of the drow were felled. The last dwarf to go down sank slowly into the stones and was gone. His essence came here, where even now he waits on the level below, a statue holding the chalice of healing waters. Only the pure of heart, those who mine the gems of earth for unselfish goals, may hold the chalice. Okay. Well, what's this one say? Translate, Vonar! Hey. I said translate. Vonar, do your job. You wily thief. Here. Translate. Okay, apparently he can't translate that one, so we'll hold on to it instead. Interesting. And I just can't believe there's nothing here. That's just kind of a bummer. But oh well. At least this is a mostly straight shot. Wall. Let's see, there were some spells and stuff still on this level, but we really don't need them. So I'm thinking we're just going to proceed deeper into the mines, and I think we can drop these. So deeper we go. Okay, now I think we'll be fighting the savants more or less regularly as part of the Darrow forces. And the trick to them is the exact same as the other one. You close to melee as fast as you can, and they won't blast your ass with a lightning bolt. I think they can do some other stuff too, like I believe they pitch fireballs, and I'm pretty sure they can cast cones of cold, which if one of those hits us, it's probably gonna kill somebody, because we ain't got that many hit points. Close to melee, no savant. Oh wow, he's a weak one. Somebody got stiffed on those hit die rolls. Let's see what else awaits. Okay. Putting myself between this one and that one in the background. Okay. And nothing in here either. Dang. And now I'm gonna find a Kyogtom's ointment down here and be like, I wonder if I could make it there before... what's his name? Dies of poisoning. And then I'll probably try it and fail. Now, I know I saw another one of those suckers over there. I did. Ouch. Oh wow, there are a couple of you guys in here. There only looked like there were two. Jeez. Damn it, not what I wanted to do. I thought I clicked on neutralize poison. Okay, you guys want to play like this? Fireball. I forgot these guys had magic resistance. Decidedly not good. Draw strength. Oh, so that does give her strength. I think that's, I want to check. I think that'll pump her up to an 18 strength score. Oh, 17. Eh, not bad. Better off than she is. Okay. Gauntlets of Stone Giant Strength. Yeah, 20 strength score. He's gonna be a killing machine now. Cause once you get above the 18-100 strength, the bonuses get really crazy pretty fast. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, that's what it does, though. And people wondered why 2-Weapon Fighters were so popular in 2nd Edition. Well, 1st Edition, too. And we have a sling pouch now, with some stones, so should she ever go into the back row, she has something to do now. And there's something else lying around here. Oh. Okay. What is this? Nothing but decoration, apparently. Do we have anybody in here? No. And a warhammer. Non-magical. Don't care. My god, this place is a maze. That was weird. Okay, we got a... God damn it, I hate... Oh, swells down. Shit. Yeah, that's like an instant reload right there. Menahath dead. Where did we last save? Oh darn. Yeah. Map. In that case... in that case, what I think I'm going to do is call it an episode here and get us back to where we were, more or less. I'll get us down to the entrance of the next level before next video, and I'll probably clear this level over too, just for XP and whatnot. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you folks next time.